Hello everyone. Let us analyze a metal company, yet another metal company, an NPA. Company is incorporated in 93 for cast steel, rolled products, seamless tubes and pipes. And then limits appraised for 220 crores. And then scheduled to be completed in 95. Cost of the project increased by 20 crore. Delay in implementation in the project due to cost overrun and infrastructure problems, like delay in supply of critical equipment, delay in delivery of machinery, technical problems in trial run in the tube plant and the reheating furnace. So the cost has again gone up another 30 crores, total 273 crores made by promoters by sanction of additional term loan and funding of interest and rescheduling of existing term loan. So this is a case of a company going bad even before it is starts function. The company faced various problems during implementation of the project, became sick as it could not sustain continuous production, heavy cost burden and depreciation. Project could not be completed. The company which had started its trial run suspended the trial run due to increase in power tariff, cost of production, change in government policy, and finally shut down. And the account became irregular, devolvement of LCs is there, non-payment of quarterly interest, and became NPA. The company could not complete the project due to erosion of the entire net worth by internet, approached AFR, its hearing was held, declared the company as sick, an operating agency with a rehabilitation scheme, viability study, found to be viable subject to certain reliefs and concessions, revised rehabilitation proposal, revival was accepted in principle, rehabilitation was proposed, it was circulated, approved, with the right of recompense subject to certain conditions, opinion was conveyed, certain reliefs and concessions were agreed, but no additional working capital was sanctioned. So because the bench could not insist on additional capital, would not be getting equal treatment in repayments with others who are willing to give additional capital, okay, and no staff losses were there, delay in implementation. How simple it is. Now what exactly is wrong here? From the bank's point of view, it should have become clear to the bank that it is a metal sector, heavy gestation period, capital intensive project, and the promoter's capacity to bring in additional money in case of hike in the project cost by at least up to 20% sensitivity analysis. That sensitivity analysis was not done, 20% of hike in the price. If they would have done this 20% sensitivity analysis, it would have come up to them, they would have understood that the promoters are in no way, no position to bring in the additional capital that is required. And the second thing was about the technology that is being implemented. Obviously, the technology that is implemented is second-hand technology. The project is only a rehashed version of a failed project elsewhere abroad. They brought in mostly second-hand machinery. They dismantled it elsewhere, brought it here, took it up. That's why it failed. Some equipment could not come, trials and could not be completed. Cost of operation was very high, extremely unviable. So all these things come when the project itself is a second-hand project and the machinery is brought in is a second-hand machinery, and no check is done by the bank through an independent consultant as to what is the status of the technology that is being brought in. See, cost overrun, cost of production being too much, not viable, unviable cost of production, economic viability being not there. That's the first thing that you see, economic viability and technical feasibility. both the things have failed here, and it is a clear case of appraisal defect, and then finally the bank says no staff accountability. There is no case, very few cases, I don't know, I have not heard of any case where for lack of capacity to appraise the proposal, lack of competence to appraise the proposal, especially a greenfield project, especially capital intensive project, especially metals project, where a lot of things can go wrong and the technology has to be checked twice and thrice. See, you cannot stop making steel in BC kind of technology, it had to be latest. Who bothered about it? Nobody bothered about it. And finally it said, because the project could not be implemented, so everybody is washing their hands off. This kind of washing of hands is what is at the bane, at the center of all NPA woes in India. Banks cannot wash off their hands because they are unable to analyze a project, because they are unable to clearly understand the technology that is there, state of the art, and they are unable to compare it with the kind of technology that is being brought in. They cannot wash their hands off the fact that when people are bringing in second-hand machinery and taking away the hard-earned savings of Indian people, banks as custodians, as trustees, they have every business to be alert. And when they are not alert, some big head has to roll. Whoever has approved that project is correct. Unfortunately, we depend on some vague technical consultancy organization or a consultant hired by the promoter to be underlined. Naturally, because he is being paid by the promoter, he will sing the song of the promoter, and the banks very blindly go along. As the Bank of India, when it is seeing such cases as this, should analyze that lack of capacity in the credit department of the banks in pinpointing whether a particular greenfield project that is coming to them is of the highest order in technology, is of the highest order in plant and machinery that is being sourced, whether the sources, the suppliers are very, very renowned, and whether the new machinery is coming or an old machinery, old plant is being dismantled elsewhere abroad because it has failed there and is being brought in as a new company and being set up here. Thank you for watching.